Good afternoon, guys. My name is Kenny, and you're watching Brave the Wilds on YouTube. So, as you guys probably saw if you watched my last video on this wood stove, I test burned it. I built this the exact same way that I built my last stove, and I have a video on that if you're curious. It's called Homemade Filing Cabinet Stove, I believe, or something like that. So it lasted for a whole season, and I was very impressed with it, and if I'd kept up on maintenance with it, it probably would have lasted enough to where I could probably use it this season as well, but the paint on the top, the high temp paint that I had on there, wore off and it rusted. So I basically had to make another one. So once again, I got another filing cabinet from a neighbor for free. So I haven't really put any money in this at all, besides the stove pipe, and I'll talk about that in a minute. So I haven't spent any money on it, and it took a couple hours. It's definitely a time consuming process, but I think it's a lot better than paying for a $200 wood stove. It's actually 4 inches wider than my last stove, so it should crank off a little bit more heat and have a little bit more cooking area, which should work quite well. The door, I've done a few changes, and I'm going to finish doing those changes tonight. Instead of a eye bolt fed through to do the door latch, it's going to be a, well, this should be a little bit here. I think I bent it a little bit. But basically, it'll just be a piece right here that this will drop down into and lock in the door, and then lift it up, and it should open very easily. So I'm going to work on that here in a little bit. And then my airflow system, I'm going to try and do some work on that tonight. It's a bit loose. As you can see, I didn't plan on it being that loose, but basically it's just a hinge piece, which is a pop rivet, excuse me. All it is just a piece of metal cut out, and it's got a little handle on here right here made of another pop rivet. Basically, the idea is when you don't want any airflow, obviously, you would just have it all the way closed. And then if you want a little bit of airflow, you can drop it and adjust it. And then if you want a full open, you just leave it like so. This will be up here out of your way. So it will work just like so. But as you can see, it's a bit loose. So what I'll probably do is drill out this rivet and put a bolt through there so I can adjust the tightness of it. So that way it will be a friction fit to hold it here or closed or anywhere in between. So we'll have a good control of our airflow. This one doesn't have, the door of this one doesn't have as many holes in it as the last one, so I should be able to control it just a little bit better. I do also have a damper that I'm going to be installing in this piece of pipe tonight as well. So basically all I have to do is get all the excess crap off of here. As you can see, there's a bunch of paint leftovers, residue kind of stuff that's gotten on here. That was definitely the easiest paint burning I've done so far. The other one took me a couple hours because I had to get it hotter, but I didn't have the idea of a leaf blower back then, so as you saw, that was pretty violent and really fun to do. It definitely wore all this paint off very, very quickly and very easily, and it was definitely a lot of fun. So I guess we'll go and talk about the stove pipe itself. See if I can get the whole thing in frame there. Maybe not. I'm going to have to back this thing up. Keep going. There we go. So the pipe itself is 6-inch pipe, just like the last pipe I was using, except this time instead of getting 3 2-foot sections and 3 elbows, which is what it took, either that or it was 2 elbows, something like that, instead of getting all that again, because stovepipe is quite expensive, I decided to get 1 piece of 5-foot 6-inch pipe. The benefit of that is this pipe was $7 and a $4 damper, compared to $5 a piece for 2-foot sections and $5 for an elbow. So it would be $34 to buy all that other pipe. This right here was $11. So obviously a big difference in price. All I'll do is run the pipe out of the roof instead of out of the side. So I'll just have to make sure and caulk around the entrance or where the pipe goes through the cabin roof. I'll have to come up with some kind of metal there to keep it obviously from melting the tarp. And so I will have to do a little bit of modification, but if it saves me $20, then I think it's worth it. So that'll be something that I'll do as well tonight. So I'll go ahead and put the damper in there. And then after that, I'll paint it up with some high temperature paint, and it will be done. So I'll kind of give you a little bit of shots here and there of me working on it. Nothing too special. This is probably going to be one of the last cabin renovations videos besides the move-in day, which hopefully will be September 27th, is when I'll move in everything from the cabin this weekend. Which should be the 21st, which is Saturday, 21st of September. I will be cleaning it, doing a thorough job working on it, and then the 27th will be move-in day, hopefully. So I'll go ahead and just show you a little bit of work while I'm doing on this, and then the next video in the series will be the last one for 2013, where I will be finishing up the cabin renovations, and camping season will start hopefully September 27th, if not the following weekend. So I'll go ahead and show you guys a little bit of what I'm doing as I go, but besides that, you know, we're getting real close to camping season. Probably be easier to do if you had a pressure washer, which I have, but I don't feel like breaking it out tonight. But as you can see, that did a very good job of burning all the paint off of the side. I mean, I know it's hard to tell in the lighting, but it looks really nice. It's all nice and gray and down to the bare metal right here. As you can see, it had a lot of pink stuff that's getting wiped up fairly easy, so it definitely looks a lot better. And I know this is bare metal, so when I put my high temp paint on there, I know it's not going to chip off, and there's no, you know, paint left on there to get burned off while it's in the cabin and possibly, you know, get in our lungs and, you know, mess us up a little bit. I don't know if burning paint inside of a cabin is a good idea. So you definitely want to get all that stuff off because, yeah, it can be toxic if it's burned off. So I'm going to go ahead and finish cleaning this thing up, and I pretty much think I'm going to paint it and call it a night. Well, as you can see, we let the paint dry overnight and it looks real good. It's real sleek. You want to make sure you get all the paint off of this before you paint it, because when you go to do another burn, it will bubble off again, and it's going to bubble off your high temperature paint. Now this stuff does smoke when it's first applied, so you want to make sure you burn it outside again one more time before you take it inside, because this paint does smoke for a little bit, but then you're pretty much good to go after that. So it looks real good. Hopefully I won't have to build another one, but this one does have a lot more support in the top, and it is twice as thick at the bottom, so it should work out real well. Hopefully you guys will see it a lot this winter. We'll do a lot more wilderness cooking videos and stove cooking videos this winter. Our first camp out is going to be this Friday night. Might film it, might not completely sure, but pretty much from then on we'll be camping out every Friday night, so stay tuned for that. This will be the last video in the cabin renovation series, and then from then on it's going to be Chapter the Hut continued after this. So thank you guys for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Have a good day, and I'll see you in the next video.